as an idiot, idealist, law student, the earlier days of law school, I used to feel the laws are there, the judges are there to implement it. What exactly is the purpose of lawyers? When I graduate, will I even have a job or will I be out starving on the streets? I got my answer in the final year of law school when I was assisting a senior counsel in filing an SLP, a specially petition before the Honorable Supreme Court. What had happened was the client was a junior engineer in some department in Haryana. The allegation against him was that to rehook the electricity of a particular farmland, the complainant man came and said to the vigilance department that this gentleman, this junior engineer, came and demanded a bribe. And so he was caught, prosecution was launched, he ultimately was terminated from his job as well, and a sentence of conviction, I think around 2 or 3 years of imprisonment was also awarded, fine was also awarded, and of course the man lost all the prospects of his job, the salaries that he would have gotten. The matter came up to the Supreme Court, we did our drafting, it was pointed out for the very first time after a conviction by the special court, that is the Sessions Court in the matter, dealing with the matter, and before the High Court as well, this point was never raised, that under the Prevention of Corruption Act, it's a very, very fundamental tenet, that for illegal gratification, that is bribe, there must be two components for a conviction to be sustainable. One is that the amount was received, but more importantly, that a demand was made of illegal gratification. Now in here, in this case, to prove the case of demand of illegal gratification, the complainant man testifies that he had, before that whole raid and the money being recovered, he had never met the junior engineer accused person. But he testified that his mother told him when he came back from the fields in the evening that this junior engineer man came and he asked for this money from her. The mother never came to testify in the court as to what was the demand or what were the other circumstances around the situation. And clearly, the idealistic law student, having read the law of evidence, came up with this point that this was hearsay evidence. The person says that my mother told me, and the person testifies to this, the mother never comes to testify. Therefore, there was never ever established to the slightest extent any demand, any proof of demand of illegal gratification. At this stage, you know, if this thing would have been done at the very initial stages, success would have been almost inevitable. An acquittal would have happened. But before the Honorable Supreme Court, when we tried to agitate this point strongly for the very first time, the Honorable Court just asked this one question: did you ever agitate this point at any point of time before the trial court or even before the High Court in appeal? Here in special leave to appeal, we are not going to entertain these grounds. However, the court was kind enough to allow the SLP to the extent that the time undergone by the person, which was about 1 month, it was that the period of sentence was reduced to the period already undergone. The person did not have to spend that extra, I believe, two and a half more years of imprisonment. But something that the man desperately wanted was the back wages in this matter, because if this conviction would have been set aside, he would have gotten an acquittal. There would have been a chance that he could get his back wages in the department disciplinary proceedings as well, something he was not able to secure. It is this case that established in my mind the understanding that lawyers are very, very important, because you may have the parliament passing the law, you may have the executive, you know, implementing the law, the judiciary, you know, interpreting the law, but lawyers are there to help out the lawmakers make the law, the judges, you know, the executive execute those laws, and the judges in interpreting those laws. Every step of the way, we are needed. And if I may dare venture out and say this as well, without lawyers, law, pretty much anarchy and nothing else.